Drives, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 31-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 47-yard line.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47. He's at the 30. He's knocked out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Rose, complete touchdown. He makes the PAT. So a four-play, 69-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So the score now, 7-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 31. The Commodores have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 42.
Red two.
Gets out to around the 45.
There's nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line. From the 42-yard line, second down. Brought down at the 39. Going to hit the ground, incomplete. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. Defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Kentucky up 7 points. And they hit him in the backfield.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Quick pass, and they make the stop at about the 45. I'd say that went about as well as the defense hoped it would.
You always like to move the ball at least past midfield, if only to win the field position battle. The defense wasn't going to give them anything on that drive.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. Run right side, looking for the corner. He makes his way to about the 32, and he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Tackled after a decent pickup. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. With a quick throw, keeps a foot in and pulls it down.
That makes it first and 10.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. From the 35-yard line, first down. Smith gets another carry. Tackle around the 33-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
Here he goes. Tackle made around the 20-yard line. From the 20-yard line, it's first down.
Dog, kill, kill. Panther, shoot.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. He's got it out to his tight end. They'll bring him down at the 18. From the 18-yard line, it's third down. Throws a laser across the middle. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That's a deep 10 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. He's tackled at the 5-yard line. They're at the 5. It's second down. Touchdown, Vanderbilt.
So smoothly executed. He looked totally in control on that keeper.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Up the middle for a nice game. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Strike to the back, and he drops it. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning, where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. Got it complete, and he's out of bounds. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Down he goes at midfield.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
So it's second and 13. Ball on the 50. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 34. They'll give it off here. He's at the 20. And he's taken down at the 11. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 11.
Red 2, blue 20.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Slings it out there, incomplete. They'll line it up again on third down. He's in trouble. And they push him out at the 3. Vanderbilt could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
That brings us third and 10.
He's got it with room to run. And he shoved out of bounds around the 42-yard line. Ball on the 42-yard line. He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line. First down. Zips it to the back. He's taken down around the 32-yard line. Hang on, everybody, because it looks like they came ready to play today. 10-7, Commodore. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2. Fires quickly, and he's got his man brought down at about the 21. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 21. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Third down again. He fights forward to about the 19. Kentucky can tie it up here with this kick. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Under pressure, and he tackles him hard at the 17.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Makes it to the 27.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll bring up third and eight.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Robinson is back deep to return the punt. Oh, excellent punt. He's tackled at the 30-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Quick out to his receiver. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line. It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Davis comes away with 5 yards on the carry.
That brings him second and 5.
First down.
Nice protection, a good pass, even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap and he threw it right out there. Hands it off. And they make the stop at the 26.
He's really quick with his lateral movement, especially for a guy this big. He got to the ball carrier before he could get out of the backfield.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 26. And they'll get him in the backfield. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Larry. Watch the run.
he is drilled at the 22-yard line. Kentucky is looking to go up by three. The kick is up, and he's got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. The Commodores have got to find a way now to get the football in this guy's hands. And I think about basketball players and a jump shooter. If you can't get him the ball, get him to the free throw line and get him one free one from 15 feet.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, and this is one of those games where the defense has just been suffocated. They've taken this wide receiver out of the game. This offense has not been able to come up with some answers. I would continue to fight as an offensive coordinator and a play caller to find different ways to get this receiver in touch. And all it takes, Brad, as you said, is just one play to maybe create that spark and get this confidence established for this offense.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. Got an opening. He makes his way out to about the 35.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Red 2! Kill, kill, kill! Number 3!
He wants it all. Can't connect. From their own 35-yard line, second down. With the pass, incomplete. Here they come. They bring him down.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. Robinson fields it at the 35.
Well, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Kentucky is up by three. Pushed out of bounds around the 44-yard line.
That'll bring up second and 12.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line.
This offense right now just making good decisions, moving the sticks, and maintaining possession.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Tailback brought down for a loss.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
Even
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And so it's another third down upcoming here.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation.
Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Loss of a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Kentucky has a three-point lead. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tackle around the 34-yard line. From their own 34-yard line, it's first down. Slings it. They'll bring him down around the 28-yard line. We've got second and long. Ball on the 28. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. To his tailback again. Tackle made around the 49-yard line. That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down. From their own 49-yard line, first down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Knocked out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. A pickup of four on the play.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
Looks middle, got his back. And he's tackled at the 32.
That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. He steps out
around the 29-yard line.
This is the eighth play of this drive. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's taken down at about the 13.
Well played by the offensive line to sell the defense on the pass rush and then get out in front to make some room for the screen.
Black five, black five. Orange three, orange.
Here's the give. Runs outside for a nice gain.
Kill, kill.
That brings him second and five.
Under heavy pressure. And he's sacked.
Get up, get up, get up.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. As a man, he'll lose big yards. They're stopped for a 6-yard loss on the play.
So that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Vanderbilt is down 3 and looking to tie it up. He gets it up, and he got it. And we'll go into halftime here with a score all deadlocked.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the strip stick, you know, be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, you know, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. You're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Is it stinky?
Yes.
Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Well, we welcome you back to the action. Just about set to start the second half in a tie ball game. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. He's taken down at about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. On the ground, left side. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards. First down.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. And down he goes at the 41-yard line.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker, and he got through almost untouched.
Tackled outside after a nice pickup. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. Hey. Dumps it complete over the middle. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
Robinson is back awaiting the punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Here's a running play. He's to the 40. And they finally knock him out at the 50-yard line. From midfield, it's first down. Now he tries to buy some time. Tries to get around the corner. And they make the stop
around the 37-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
He's tackled
at about the 37-yard line.
That makes it second and 10. From the 37-yard line, second down.
Aidy's getting the ball here. Aidy's getting the ball. Mike 10. Mike 10. Mike 10.
Two for step. Motion. Two.
Motion. Motion.
There's a strike complete. That's a great tackle at the 20. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. Run, left side. He fights forward to about the 19. Makes it to the 18-yard line.
Gain of one on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
From the 18-yard line, it's third down. Goes to the end zone.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Kentucky could take the lead with this field goal.
There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
Still fourth down.
Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Kicks away, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 25.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Here's a quick throw. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one. He's under pressure. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Sack. It's now fourth and long. Robinson, back to return it. And this one is a beauty. Robinson fields it at the 42. They'll bring him down at the 45. Well, Vanderbilt's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie, I guess, at least not today.
No, not today. They played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
They're set to go for another round. Kentucky is up a field goal. And he's leveled at the 48-yard line.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. Steps up under pressure, and he hits him hard at the 44-yard line. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Barry is the punter. Shepard fields it at the 13. He's tackled at the 28. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Has some daylight. And they push him out at the 43. First and 10, ball on the 43. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Into the open field. He gets to about the 34-yard line.
That's good for him, 19 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. He fights forward to about the 33. And he throws it away. Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. Vanderbilt can tie it up here with this kick. Kicks up, and it's good.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
So our score, Vanderbilt 16, Kentucky 16. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. And he carries the ball for a nice game. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And he is drilled at the 34-yard line. Receiver, and he can't make the grab. Barry awaits the snap. Knocked out of bounds around the 23-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Just throws this one away. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 23. After a decent pickup.
That's a game seven on the play. That makes it third and three.
And two.
And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch.
I don't know what game plan this offense is running, but it might need to be reassessed by this coaching staff. The defense decided to go conservative, sitting back in cover three. They wanted to make sure the receiver was not going to get open past the first down line on that play.
Robinson, the return man. Booming kick. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it 7-6.
From the 50, second down. Throws incomplete. So we played three quarters of football, and with one quarter to go, we're in a deadlock. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Taken down around the 40-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
From the 40-yard line, first down. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
and they got to him before he could get back to the line.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. If they can get some protection, they might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
That brings us fourth and 11.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Tackle at the 28-yard line.
That's a that makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He's to the 40. Got an opening. And he's finally taken down at the 47.
First down.
From the 47-yard line, first down. He's scrambling. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
You know, the safety's responsibility, Brad, is to always make sure nothing is going to get behind him. He cannot ever get beat deep. But also, he has a responsibility to step up and make a play on the football in front of him. It's just another example of a defensive back, in this case a safety, just having really good instinct to be able to come up and know when to come up to knock that ball away.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Got a man. Watch out here. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line.
Childress brings him down at the 28-yard line. First down.
Snags it complete out of bounds, though, and they're going to lose yardage. Second down at 12. Ball on the 30. Makes it out to about the 16.
That makes it first and 10.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Tackled after positive yardage.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Goes to his back, and it's in and out of his hands. Here's play number 10 on the drive. They'll bring him down around the 1 yard line.
Number 42 on the tackle at the 1 yard line.
First and goal, fourth quarter, all tied up. What's it going to be?
Go four!
And down he goes at the 1 yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's tackled at the 3-yard line. That was a designed quarterback draw, and it results in a loss of around two. This is a very important play for both teams. It's third and goal from the two. Touchdown, Vanderbilt.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 26. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Tackle made around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, it's first down. After a decent run up the gut. On the ground with the tailback. Makes it out to about the 49. From the 49-yard line. First down. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Brought down at about the 41. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. It's first and 10. Ball on the 28. And they'll get him in the backfield.
Call a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Just under three to go in regulation. And they make the stop around the 27-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 18. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Inside the 10. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. 13th play of the drive coming up. Five wide. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
From the 2-yard line, second down. And he's taken down at the 1.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it.
This is the 15th play of this drive. Touchdown, Wildcats. A little over a minute in the game. He makes the PAT. So a 14-play, 74-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Kentucky is ready to kick it away. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 27. What a game it's been for him running the ball, Kirk.
Well, it's a lot of fun when you're not getting touched until you get to the second level of the defense. That way he has plenty of room to be able to make some big plays.
We'll see if they put the ball in his hands on this very important drive. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here. He's out of bounds at the 36. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. He's under some heat. And he hits him hard at the 28.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
See the elation on the defensive coordinator's side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. Oh, excellent punt. Robinson takes it at the 32. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Late in the fourth quarter now, tie football game. And if we're headed to overtime, I hope it's going to be as good as what we've seen through four quarters. We have less than a minute to go. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle at the 49-yard line. Catches it, and that's all. Wildcats use their second timeout from the 47-yard line. Third down. And I think they're going to take one last shot at the end zone here. For the game. Caught. Touchdown, Kentucky. Kentucky is up by six. He splits the uprights with the extra point. The Commodores, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nussler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.